Well, by rights, I should have been born a mod. My mother did the Small Faces fan club in the 1960s, and I knew Steve Marriott and Ronnie Lane, Kenny Jones, growing up. You know, they kind of kept in touch with my family all the way through the 70s. But to be honest, I didn't really get to know about mod until I saw The Jam in 1978. And I think as soon as I did, that woke me up to my interest in history. And then I can remember going, you know, my dad saying, "Oh, you know, your mum used to do that mod back." So so I got into mod like most other kids, most other men my age, for the mod revival, you know, which is mainly down to Paul Weller. Well, I think the trouble with punk was my generation. You know, I was too young for punk, and I really liked the music. I was a massive fan of the Damned and the Stranglers and all that kind of stuff. But I didn't like the clothes. I didn't like that whole pathetic anarchy, Malcolm McLaren, what we regarded as bullshit, really, anarchy. However, I like the music. And when Weller came along, when I saw The Jam, and the Buzzcocks were a very mod-like band at the same time, and almost for a little while Generation X were as well. And so there were these three bands in 1978 that made me think, you know, you can be into punk without being a punk. And obviously I wasn't alone in that, because within 6 months, The Jam had spawned the mod revival and had a whole kind of host of other bands, like the Purple Hearts, Secret Affair. I went to school with Secret Affair, well, one of Secret Affair, funny enough. And, you know, the thing about these bands were, they were fundamentally Jam fans. So they were the same age as their audience. They were kids going to see The Jam who formed bands for kids who were going to see The Jam. It's really weird. I was talking to Bob Manton, who's the lead singer of the Purple Hearts, when they did a reunion gig at the 100 Club 6 months ago. And I asked him how old he was, and he's 6 months older than me. And yet I saw that band when I was 15 years old. So he was 16 in Leicester Square, around the corner from here, in March 1979. Wouldn't that happen now? Would you get 16-year-old kids headlining gigs, sold-out gigs, to other 16-year-old kids? They wouldn't even get in. They're not allowed in. So, you know, that whole kind of mod revival thing was a real proper youth movement that came about because people were rejecting punk and embracing this thing. And from this thing, you had the whole two-tone thing split off. But people forget that when the mod revival came around, two-tone was actually part of it. And gradually that took on a life of its own. So you had a whole generation of kids that had grown up on punk but didn't like the attitude, which is why the mod revival was so big, and which is why the music press didn't like it. You know, that the establishment didn't like the mod revival because it was genuine. It wasn't created by the music press. So there was always this bitching about the mod revival, and The Jam managed to rise above that, but I think a lot of the other bands fell victim to it.